that scared the shit out of me. Hey guys, what's going on? It's your girl Hannah back at it again with another video. You already know what it is.
I'm sorry, that was cringe.
But we do that every time. So, as you can see, we are not playing Resident Evil Village today or Outlast. Today we are actually going to be playing Until Dawn. Now, this is not my first time playing this game. I have played it before. I think it was a couple years ago. And then, you know, I never finished it. So, it's a little fuzzy to me. You know, I only remember some parts in the beginning. I don't remember anything else after that. I never got to the ending. So, yes. I'm not sure when we will be, you know, posting these, you know, because I have a whole video schedule already set out for you guys. Resident Evil Village and Outlast we're already playing, and now I'm adding another one to the list, but this one, this game won't be as consistent, uploaded as, you know, the other two games. So, yes. Let's get right into this video. I'm sorry if you hear traffic. My window's open, and it's, you know, I have my fan in the window because it's extremely hot outside all the time. You know, we're in fucking summer. So, yeah. Anyways, let's get right into this game. The butterfly effect. A tiny butterfly flapping its wings today may lead to a devastating hurricane weeks from now. I wonder what that really am. Okay. Yeah. The smallest decision can dramatically change the future. This is so cool. Your actions will shape how the story unfolds. Carefully. Oh my god, here we go. Aren't the graphics just beautiful? Like, honestly? A cabin in the middle of fucking nowhere. Oh, hello. Who are you? Jason.
Oh my god.
Network error occurred. What the fuck? Sorry about that, guys. We are back. I don't know what happened. I ran into a network problem in the middle of the, I don't even know, the story. So, we'll get back.
I can't believe you actually did this.
Don't you guys think this is a little bit wrong?
Oh, come on, she deserves it.
And it's not her fault that she has a huge crush on
him. Hannah's been making the moves on him. I'm just looking out for my girl, Em.
Just because he's class prez doesn't mean he belongs to everyone. Mike is my man.
Hey, Em, I'm not anybody's man.
Whatever you say, darling.
Mike? It's Hannah.
Hey, Hannah.
No shit. So weird. Hold on. There's Jason.
Hey, did you see that?
It's you!
Dad said it'd just be us this weekend.
Josh.
Thank you. Oh, shit. This is so fucking weird. The controls are so interesting. Who's Josh? And who the hell are we? We're a mad cute sweater and everything. Like, all right, girl. You styling in for the winter? What the fuck? God damn. Oh, where are you? What is that? Tutorial to look around. Oh, yeah. Okay. Press and hold R2 to pick up the bottle. Hold R2 and use the right. Oh, the right one. Stupid, not the left one. Jeremiah Craig. Who the fuck is Craig?
Jeez, Josh. Once again, brother, you've outdone us all.
So that must be her brother. Can I go in here? Oh. I'm holding it. Oh, yeah, I got it. Hannah, you look so damn hot in that shirt, but I bet you're even hotter out of it. Come to the guest room at 2 a.m. Mike. Why am I in this game, fucker?
Oh my god.
No, I'm just kidding.
What did our naive sister get herself into now?
I don't know. I mean, she likes Mike, which
I
is
got your note.
Glad you can make it. Maybe we should start with a little, you know, making out and see where it goes from there. Oh, hell yeah.
Oh my god. She's taking her shirt off.
What? Oh my god. Matt, what are you doing here?
Hannah. I'm sorry, Hannah.
Hey,
it's all
got
out of hand.
It's
just a stupid prank. Hey, you guys are jerks. You know that? Hannah!
Oh, boy. There's our sister. Use the right. Okay, I'm using the right one. Wake Josh or find the others. Oh, wake Josh. Josh is not gonna wake up. He's fucking drunk.
Guys, there's someone outside. What the hell? Hannah! What's going on? Where's my sister going?
It's fine. She just can't take a joke.
It was just a prank, Han. What did you do?
We were just messing around, Beth. It wasn't serious.
You jerks! Hannah! Hannah!
So, should we go after her?
You know, I kind of think you're the last person she wants to see right now, Mike.
Oh, shit.
Whoa! Where? Okay. Back. Successful. Fucking successful. Follow footprints, follow noise. Footprints. Game, you know. Oh. Oh. I have foreseen the future. Jesus. We are going to die. We're going to die. Huh? What the fuck is that? A witch? A wizard? A dragon?
Hannah!
Is there a fucking dragon in the middle of the damn woods? Hello? Oh my fucking god.
What the hell was that?
A dragon. Who's that?
Hannah!
Huh?
Hannah!
Oh, we found her. What is she doing out here? Without
Hannah! Oh my god, you must be freezing. Here, take my coat. I'm such an idiot. I'm so dumb.
One.
Hannah, is that it?
Ready for this decision. Are you kidding? We are literally in the beginning of the game and I have a decision whether to drop my sister or to kill both of us. Oh my, no. No! I refuse. I refuse. But if I don't choose, then it's just automatically going to decide for me. If we drop my sister, that's going to be a dickhead move. But we could probably survive. If we drop her, we can grab the guy's hand, or whoever that is, and whoever this is will live. But if we let go of the thing, then both of them will die. Okay, I think I'm gonna be a dickhead. I think I'm gonna be a dickhead and drop my own sister. Okay, let's do it.
I'm so sorry.
Oh. We both died anyway. Oh my god. We both died anyway, so I guess it didn't matter. If we let go of the branch.
Before we begin, there are a few things I need to make sure you understand.
Who the fuck are you?
You see, no one can change what happened last year. The past is beyond our control. You have to accept this in order to move forward.
What?
But there is freedom in this revelation. Everything you do, every decision you make from now on will open doors to the future. I want you to remember this. I want you to remember this as you play your game. Every single choice will affect your fate and the fate of those around you.
Oh.
So, you have committed to commence with this game. This is significant. And I want to help you see it through. Sometimes these things can be a little scary. Even terrifying, but I'm here to make sure that no matter how upsetting things may get, you will always find a way to work through it. Hmm? All right. We will start with a simple exercise. Could you please pick up a card And I want you to look at the picture on the other side and tell me what you feel about it. It is essential that you answer honestly in order to get the most out of this experience.
Okay. Oh, creepy ass scarecrow.
So, how did that picture make you feel? Remember, be honest.
It makes me happy. I feel uneasy.
Okay, honesty is good.
Were you my therapist or something?
It is that makes you feel uneasy.
It's a scarecrow. The scarecrow.
Well, I see. Let's see. The scarecrow were not there. Would you feel comfortable staying there on your own for a period of time? Say a week, for example.
If the scarecrow were not there, then... sure.
Huh. And what if I told you that this cottage was haunted?
Yeah. I'd be scared.
Oh. All right. I sense that you suffer from a significant fear of the supernatural. What lies beyond the veil of death?
Well, I'm not going somewhere where I'm going to get possessed.
Unknown. Don't you agree? Like, and what could inspire fear more than the terror of uncertainty? Please remember, this is only a game.
Only game.
Well, we seem to be out of time for this session.
Okay.
But we'll talk again very soon.
Okay, therapist. Yeah. Okay, bye. I don't know why I need a therapist, but... maybe the game just traumatizes you to the point where you need one. I don't fucking know.
Today is the one-year anniversary of the dreadful tragedy that took place on Mount Washington. Annie Klein was in charge of the investigation.
Thanks for having me, Marty.
Listeners, an update on Hannah and Beth Washington, the twins who are still missing.
1 year ago tonight, the Washington girls left the safety of their parents' lodge and headed out into a snowstorm.
Foul play.
Not officially, no. There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest, but his whereabouts are currently unknown. He has an interesting history with the Washington family. He had warned them against pursuing their construction project and claimed the land was sacred to his forefathers.
You know, there is still the old sanatorium on the mountain. Could he be hiding there?
My officers did search the grounds, but the girls themselves couldn't have made it that far.
Something about that mountain seems to breed tragic events.
More than you know, Marty.
thank you for joining us, Andy. With all the Washingtons tonight, their son Josh, on this, the anniversary of the mysterious disappearance of Hannah and Beth Washington.
Well, hello, friends and fans. All right, let's do that again.
Whoa.
All right. Well, hello, friends and fans. It's beyond awesome to have you guys all back this year. First off, I gotta say, I am super excited to welcome all my pals back to the annual Blackwood Winter Getaway. So, let me just let you know, let's take a moment to address the elephant in the room for a second. I know you're all probably worried about me, and I know it's gonna be tough on all of us going back after what happened last year, but I just want you all to know, it means so much to me that we're doing this, and I know it would mean so much to Hannah and Beth that we're all still here together, and I'm thinking of them. I really want to spend some quality time with each and every one of you, and just share some moments that we'll never forget for the sake of my sisters, and, you know. Okay, so let's party like we're fucking porn stars, okay? Make this one trip we will never forget, all right? Yes!
I just don't understand why they would go back. Oh my god. Who is this man? And why does he keep stalking? Sam, Hannah's best friend. Diligent, considerate, and adventurous. Seems really nice. She was actually trying to warn her friend that, but she couldn't find
someone there?
It in time, so I automatically like her. The cable car station. Okay, let's go. How the fuck can you wear a skirt? Oh, I can move the camera. How can you wear a skirt in the winter? I'm sorry, but I cannot. What am I supposed to be looking for? This? What is that?
What?
The gate's busted. Climb over.
Damn it.
Chris.
Oh, Jesus. Never mind.
Yeah. Climb up. Let's do... Sorry, that's my timer. Let's do safe this time, since we're not really in a rush. Yes, we did it. Bird, where? How is he following us? He needs to stop breathing so damn hard. Like, fuck.
Aww. Hey, little fella. You hungry? Huh? Cutie.
If that's still possible. Oh no, this is gonna be hard. Cause if I move the controller now, that's gonna be. Oh god. If you're unsure of what to do next, you can see your current objective by pressing R1. Head to the cable car station. Oh look, there's relationship status. Honest, charitable, funny, brave, romantic, curious. And she pretty much likes all of them the same. Except for Jess, whoever Jess is, she's like the least that she likes. It's weird. I think it's cool. The graphics are really, really nice. But yeah, this is like my first time playing like any game that's like this.
Cool.
Oh, Native Americans. Tribes who once lived in these mountains believed that butterflies carried dreams and prophecies of possible futures. The color of the butterfly indicated the nature of the prophecy. Death. Black butterflies prophesize the dreamer's death. Danger is red. Red butterflies warned of dangerous events. Loss. Brown butterflies foretold the tragedy affecting friends. Guidance. Yellow butterflies offered visions to help and guide. Fortune. White butterflies. White butterflies brought dreams of luck and good fortune. So this is a yellow one then, right? Rotate item. Yeah, this is yellow. A bird. It was Mike and a crow. Future's uncertain, whether or not the prophecy comes true depends on the choices that you make. Press R1 at any time to view your totem collection. I have a totem collection. Oh yeah. Death. Guidance is yellow. Okay. Good to know. I'm sorry I'm yawning so much, guys. It's just like one of those days where I just can't stop fucking yawning. What the hell does this say?
Wow, the past is beyond our control. Here.
Okay, let's go over here and see if we can get in
Chris,
something.
You here?
No. I don't know why I tried that again. It wasn't working either way. Oh, look.
Mag's here. Where are you? You're not in the bag, are you? Hello. What do we have here?
His phone. Should we snoop or close the bag? Let's close it.
Maybe I shouldn't poke around Chris's stuff. Chris?
Sam, hey, you made it.
Chris has a crush on Ashley. Methodical, protective, and humorous.
Oh, so I found something kind of amazing.
What?
I'm not going to tell you. You got to see for yourself.
Sir?
Come on, it's this way.
Where?
Right around here. Gonna blow your mind.
Okay. Blow my mind. I doubt it.
Ta-da! Pretty rad, right?
Yeah!
Come on, look at these beauties.
Beauties is not the word that comes to mind. Why is this even here?
What do you mean?
What the hell is a shooting range doing at the base of a ski lodge?
Dude, have you ever met Josh's dad?
Yeah.
He thinks he's like Grizzly Adams or something. Wanna try?
No, you go ahead, Grizzly.
All right. Here goes.
Let's do this. I don't know how good my aim is, so... I don't know. The right stick. Boom. Boom. Where am I shooting at? Boom. Boom.
Wow, nice shooting ticks.
All right, I'm bad.
I'm gonna go ahead and guess it was a wild case of beginner's luck.
Nah, I don't think so, girl.
Well, anybody and their brother could shoot a bottle that big, that close.
I'm gonna shoot the bag. I love animals too much to kill them.
Nice shot.
Your ass just got sacked.
Hey, sharpshooter, a ride's coming.
Wait, I'm just getting the hang of this.
Come on, Chris, the cable car.
Butterfly effect updates. Interesting. Oh, now we're playing as Chris. Oh, sorry, didn't mean to pause it. I meant to go here, actually. It's honest. Charitable, funny, brave. He's not very brave. Romantic and curious. He doesn't like Jess, Matt, or Mike. He likes Sam, Josh, and Ashley. Those are his top three people that he likes.
It's definitely weird coming back up here after a whole year.
Yeah, I swear, the moment I got here, it all came flooding back.
Quick clues to solve the mysteries of Until Dawn.
Look at this.
Nice. You think we'll get a visit from America's Most Wanted?
Looks like someone thought so.
Oh, come on, this place is...
Hey, that's weird. Door's locked.
Yeah.
Yeah, we tried it before.
Josh wanted us to keep it locked to keep people out.
He said that? What people?
I don't know. You said they found people sleeping in the station one time.
That's creepy.
I do it.
After you.
Oh, real gentleman.
Where am I going? I'll go in here. I don't know where here is, but...
And I thought the car was closer.
Guess we gotta wait.
I'm starting to get the appeal of killing time at the shooting range.
Healthy body.
How long is this gonna take?
Okay.
What a crazy place to set up house. I mean, no matter how rich you are.
Not so rich.
There we go. It wasn't working.
Bottom out.
Damn, are we gonna look at this fucking picture all fucking day?
Finally, you coming?
Yeah, well, I was gonna stay here and catch some Z's, but... Okay.
We'll go in.
Just like going to the prom.
Here we go.
Right. Adventure begins.
Oh, I hope this was the right thing to do.
What?
You know, getting everyone together on the anniversary. I mean, Josh seemed really pumped about us all doing something, didn't he?
Yeah, no, he definitely did. I haven't seen him so excited about something in forever.
Good, good. It's hard to tell with him, and I've kind of been worried.
No, it was a good idea.
I hope everyone else feels the same way.
We're all here, aren't we?
Thanks, bro. Good talk.
You know what? Let's just stop talking about what happened and enjoy the trip.
You know what? You're right.
You know how Josh and I met?
No.
Okay. Third grade. Josh sat in the back of the room. I sat in the front. We didn't even know each other existed. But the kid sitting next to Josh started strap snapping the training bra on the girl in front of him. So the teacher made him move to the front, where I was sitting.
Okay, so?
So, I got moved to the back.
And?
And next to Josh. That's how we met. I mean, and became friends to this day.
A match made in heaven.
If it weren't for the fact that Jeannie Simmons hit puberty like 3 years early, and on that day decided to wear a low-cut shirt that showed off her training bra, I mean, who knows? You could be riding in this cable car alone. Right now. Or talking to some other person entirely. Boom. Butterfly effect.
I have a lot of new videos to make, guys. Oh, Jess. Mike's new girlfriend. Confident, trusting, and irreverent. How many fucking girlfriends does this guy have? Because first, Hannah likes him. And then when Hannah had a crush on him, he was with Emily or whatever. And now he's with this chick.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy. New people. Time to meet and greet.
Jess! Hey!
Jessica! Over here! Are you guys having a really weird stroke?
We're stuck in this stupid thing.
Can you please let us out? Pretty please?
Oh my god. I thought we were goners. Another 10 minutes in there and I would have chewed off my own leg.
Oh, sick, Chris.
Look, I got a lot of meat on my bones. It's all muscle down here.
Yeah, right. Hey!
well, what do we have
Chris.
Here? My goodness. Seems that someone has a little crush on our good friend and dear class president Michael Monroe.
Chris.
And what kind of sizzling erotica might our Jessica be capable of imagining? I wonder.
Mike and M split. We're together.
Whoa. Drama.
Not really. Pretty clear cut, actually. M's out, I'm in.
Huh.
All right. Let's just get up to the lodge already. It's getting tired of all this nature and junk.
You guys go ahead. I'm just gonna wait here for a bit. See who else is coming.
You mean Mike?
What? I mean... You know, whoever.
Uh-huh. Sam?
Did you see this view? I mean, holy cow. Sometimes I forget to just stop and take it all in.
Seriously, couldn't they have built the lodge, like, right where the cable car ends?
Emily, Mike's ex. Intelligent, resourceful, and persuasive.
I don't think it would have been, like, as pretty...
Matt, Emily's new boyfriend. Motivated, ambitious, and active.
No.
And where's the bellboy when you need one?
Clearly, the bellboy is your fucking boyfriend. He's over here carrying his own luggage and yours. And you're not even doing anything.
Kind of creeped out.
But fucking complaining. Yeah.
Gonna be weird seeing everyone up here again.
You're definitely not gonna feel like a regular party. Like, I mean,
I hate girls.
But what do you think? Ah!
Jesus!
Mike, Emily's ex. Intelligent, driven, and persuasive.
You guys.
Michael!
You really, really should have seen your faces right
there. Dude, I almost clocked you just now.
Nice one.
Michael, you're a jerk.
Come on. Guys, we're all friends here, right? No need for violence, just a little harmless fun. We're up in the woods, spooky. Come on, let's get into the spirit of things.
The spirit of things? Seriously, what's wrong with you?
I'm just trying to lighten the mood, Em. Don't be like that.
Like what?
The way you're being. You always get like this.
We're all friends here. Yeah.
Michael, I'm just gonna lay it out. Otherwise, this whole weekend's gonna suck ass for everyone. This is super awkward, and we all know it. Let's just acknowledge it now and move on, okay?
Yeah.
Matt.
I hear you, man. I get it. I don't want to make this weird.
Cool. So we're good?
All good.
You guys gonna make out now?
Oh my god, totally. We're so gonna make out. No. Seriously, I'm gonna go check on the cable car back on the trip.
All right. See you, man.
See ya.
All right.
See ya.
Oh, crap.
What?
Hey, could you take these the rest of the way?
The bags?
Yeah. All the bags.
Why?
I need to go find Sam.
Okay.
Sorry, I really need to go find her. I totally forgot I needed to talk to her before we get all the way up there.
This really can't wait. We're almost there.
It's important.
I think this is some
bullshit. Matt, please.
Sam's already up there, though. I'm not leaving you alone. Fuck.
I really don't think you should head back down the trail by yourself.
Seriously?
It's cold out and it's getting dark.
You're gonna protect me from it being dark out?
I'll just leave your stuff here and come with you. Nobody's gonna steal it.
Matt, are you kidding me? You can't leave me alone for 5 minutes? You really think that little of me?
That's not what I meant.
Why can't you just listen to me? Why do you have to question everything I say?
I'm sorry, Em. I'm just trying to be helpful.
If you want to be helpful, then you can help get everything
He's
up to the lodge as quickly as you can,
you.
Okay?
Wow.
Okay. Fine. Whatever you want.
Thank you. I'll see you up there after I go find Sam.
See you in a bit.
She's going to see Mike. I know that for a damn fact. Ashley has a crush on Chris, academic, inquisitive, and forthright. Cool. What the fuck are we? Oh.
Whoa, hello. Somebody's getting a little friendly. And not in the friend zone kind of way.
I know.
They might need to check the expiration date on their big breakup.
Insane. And they both have new boyfriends and girlfriends. And they're talking to other people. And that's a little, it's a little sus, man.
Oh!
Oh, God!
Hey, whoa. Sorry there. Sorry about that, Ash. I didn't mean to scare
Jeez
you.
Louise, what?
Well, I did mean to scare you, sort of scare you, but not like for real scare you.
Oh my gosh, oh my gosh!
Hey, wow. Man, I'm really sorry, Ash, damn.
It's okay, it's fine, it's fine.
What are you looking at? See anything juicy with that thing? Let me check it out.
Miss Lee, it's busted. Or encourage, take a look. You know what? I think he needs to know that his girlfriend is going back to her ex. I think he needs to know.
Sure. Go ahead. Knock yourself out. Yes.
Oh, son of a bitch. Seriously, Emily? What the hell, man?
Hey, listen, it's probably nothing.
Nothing, you think?
Well, yeah.
Is it ever just nothing with him?
No.
Ever?
I don't know.
God damn it.
Matt.
I know that was probably a dickhead move, but, like, he deserves to know that he's being cheated on. And this bitch, she's probably never gonna find out because she's, you know, dumb. Read a book or check phone. She looks like the type to check phone.
Oh, you did not just do that.
Put your hands where I can see them. We've got you surrounded.
But who am I to retaliate? What choice do I, a supple young rebel girl, have but to surrender to the strapping military guard come to take me into custody?
Well, I don't know when you put it like that. Hey! Oh! Great. Hey, you know that? Where are you hiding, little chickadee? Oh! Ah! Hey!
Oh, snap! Hello? Come on. Hey, Mike. Boom, shakalaka.
Okay. Oh, you got me. Okay.
You can't hide from me, Michael. I know all your tricks.
Sometimes doing nothing is the right thing to do. Boom!
Whoa! Ow.
Sorry, I haven't talked to
you.
And then what?
Fucking game.
Still more.
Oh yeah, oh more. Oh, you're going down. Gotcha! Done! Done city!
So did I go down?
I don't think so.
I think you'd know so if I did.
Alright, alright.
My. So are we calling it my favor then?
Your worthy opponent, Miss Jessica the Snowball Queen.
Okay, that sounds vaguely dirty.
My lady.
Might as well.
Wow. Save some for later, buddy.
Endless reserves. We should get up to the lodge.
Yeah. It's so nice out here, though. Pretty breathtaking.
I mean, I could stay out here for pretty much ever, provided I was making out with you the whole time.
Just making out?
Quote, unquote.
Well, I think we might freeze to death somewhere in between those quotes.
Yeah.
Anyways, oh, hi, therapist, man.
Hello again.
Yes, hi.
And how are we feeling?
I am all right.
In our last session, we established that you have a fear of things
Very good.
That are dead or undead.
No.
This time, we're going to try to understand the root of your anxiety.
Okay.
Now pick up that book, turn the pages. You will see a set of pictures and symbols. I want you to identify which image in each set makes you the most anxious.
which makes me the most anxious. Men worry me or women worry me? To be honest, both. Women don't really worry me because they ain't got shit on me. Yeah. Oh, flip. Crowds or planes? Planes scare me or crowds scare me? Crowds don't scare me. I just don't like being crowded. So I guess planes. Yes. Okay. I fear drowning. Oh my god, I fear heights. Yes. No, I can't even stand on a chair, bitch. I fear snakes or rats scare me. It's definitely snakes. Yep. Okay. Guns are scary or knives are scary? Oh boy, this is a tough one. Because just seeing somebody run after you with a knife is scary in the middle of nowhere. But since, you know, drive-bys do occur here, they are a little scary just to hear gunshots, like, in the random. So, I guess guns are more scary because they're more, people, you know, they're more used. You hear people, like, every day getting shot by a gun. You don't really hear a lot of people getting, like, stabbed to death. So, yes, guns are scary. Okay, cockroaches or snakes? Snakes, still. I'm not a snake person. I just cannot. Oh, yes. I don't. Yeah, that's not me. Gore disgusts me or crows are scary? Gore doesn't really disgust me that much. Crows are not scary either. I mean, I guess it depends on the gore, you know?
Oh.
Hello.
Did that startle you? So sorry.
Not really.
You're doing very well.
My microphone's not very good.
Don't be nervous.
Or my one earpiece that we're using.
Try to speed up a bit. The more you rely on your instincts, the more honest your answers will be, and the more enlightening you will find this experience.
Okay. Still. So, I'm going to end it here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy this episode, or whatever you want to call it, episode, video, please make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel and become part of the fam. So yeah, that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye guys.